Hello everyone, welcome back to Like Cookies. In today's video, we are going to meet with game components. First of all, what is a game component? It is a piece of code with some functionality that you can apply to one or multiple game objects. The game objects that have this component will have the functionality of the component. For example, we can have a player and we might want to make the player move. But why would we even consider using game components? The thing is, in Blender we can use logic bricks, right? Well, matter of fact, we already have a video that teaches us how to apply character controls with logic bricks. And it looks quite simple. The thing is, sometimes with logic bricks, everything becomes a mess. When there are too many logic bricks, even though they are more intuitive, we get lost into wires and logic bricks and which logic brick is in which object. And with components, we can just write a single component with some functionality and then apply it to every single object. And we won't have to keep track of logic bricks and wires and which logic brick is connected to which. And everything becomes just more organized. Now we're facing two questions. How to create a game component and how to bind it to a game object. To show you, first I will add another panel and it will be Logic Bricks Editor. Then I will split this panel again and the new one will be Text Editor. In the Text Editor we will create and edit the game component, and in the Logic Bricks Editor we will bind the component to our player. Here we have a templates tab, and as you can see there is another tab, Python component. There are all kinds of Python component templates. We'll use character controller basic. You can guess what this component will do. The game component in the Blender game engine is represented by a Python class. And here we have a custom Python component, which inherits from the base Python component class in the Blender game engine. What we can see here is what's called a doc string. It's simply a string that explains what the class functionality is. And here we can see W moves forward, A turns left, S moves backwards, and D turns right. So we're assuming that when we attach this component to our object or our player will have this functionality. Now next to the implementation, we also have arguments. We'll talk about these later. And we have two methods. The first method is start, and it basically has to set up the component. Then we have the update method. This method and all the update methods of all other components that are being used in our game are called every single frame. This method keeps track of the keyboard inputs and respectively updates the location and rotation of every object that has this component. Let me know if you would like to know more about the scripts and the Python programming language. I have used Python for some time now, and I will be glad to help you learn it if I can. Now to bind the component to our player, I'll come here and press on register component. And you can see here that it requires a module and a component. The module is the name of the file of the component. So I will come here and copy it. Says character controller basic. You can as well write it, of course. And then here, instead of component, enter the name of your component. So third person. Then press OK. Now if I open the component, you can see move speed and turn speed. Remember I told you that I will be explaining the arcs here? As you can see, the arcs are basically variables with a default value, which are presented by the UI of the game engine. The default values are set here, but you can update the value here. Here you can see that I can update the movement speed and the turn speed. Now to show you what's happened, I'll press P to play. And if I press W, you can see that I move forward. If I press S, I move backwards. If I press A, I rotate left. And if I press D, I rotate right. And I can combine every movement. Let's see what happens if we update the move speed. Let's say 0.2. I press W now, and I don't know if you can see this, but we move twice as fast as before. Then we have the turn speed. Let's set something crazy. And press P to play, and if I press A now, you can see that we spin crazy fast. We can tweak these and make your character as you wish. Let me set these two to their initial values, and let's check then. What will happen if we add a comb, let's say. Here's a cone, and then I will add the same game component here. By default, it remembers the last game component we have registered. So let's see what happens now. We can move, but you can't see that the cone is rotating because it's a cone. But you can see that I can control every object that has the component. Now you can check all the templates here for a Python component and tweak them around and tell me what you got. Please let me know what you would like to see next, and huge shout out to my patrons. Thank you for your support, and I'll see you next time.